Hi everybody, and welcome to your free Ornament Girl tutorial. My name is Kennedy, and today I'll be showing you how to make the adorable ginger ornament. Make sure you check out this link or the link below the video to download your free printable supply list so that you can gather all of the tools and materials you'll need to start your ornament. In order to complete this pattern, you'll need disc-shaped foam, straight pins, rickrack and gimp trim, beads in the colors black, red, white, and pink, a couple of bead caps, a few pieces of metallic hanger string, and the tools you'll need include scissors, a flexible tape measure, a pen for drawing on your fabric, and a dime will be helpful to outline the shape of the circles we need to cut out from our fabric. Again, be sure to check out the link for your free printable supply list so that you can get the breakdown of all of the quantities and sizes for your materials. Once all of your tools and materials are gathered, we can get started making your ginger ornament. We'll start by covering your disc-shaped foam with the brown fabric to make the base of our little gingerbread face. So starting with a 4-inch square of fabric number 1, lay this on your working surface, and if you have a pattern, make sure you have your fabric laying with the pattern side facing away from you. And center your disc on top of this square. It doesn't need to be absolutely perfect, but you want to try to have equal amounts of fabric on each side of the disc. And then slide that off of your working surface so that you can hold the fabric on top of the foam. And flip that over. And with a satin straight pin, you're just going to press a pin right into the middle. This is temporary. We're just leaving it there to hold our fabric in place on our foam. And now the goal is to stretch this fabric over this half of the foam and keep it as smooth as possible. And we'll always be placing our pins along this equator line. The equator is the mold line running around the center of your disc, and we want to keep all of our pins as close to that equator as possible. So starting with one of my corners, I'm just tugging so that the fabric smooths out over the rounded shape of the foam. And with my pin, I'm following this equator and pinning in line with the corner, but keeping my pin on that equator line. Now I'll switch over and do the opposite corner. Again, of course, keeping my pin as close to that equator as possible. And I'll do that for the remaining two corners. And now we want to smooth down the sides. So again, you're going to tug at them a little bit because the goal is to have this disc covered with the fabric as smoothly as possible. So I'm going to tug on that side and pin, keeping my pin on the equator, and I'll do that for all four sides of the fabric. Once we have our fabric secured, our goal here is to smooth out the edge of this fabric at the equator as much as possible. So I'm going to go around now and place one pin along the equator between each of the pins that I already have placed, always smoothing my fabric out from the center before I pin. And I'll do that all the way around. And once you have all of those pins placed, you can go around one more time and place two or three pins in between each of the pins that are already there. So I'm making a pretty solid pin line all the way around my foam here, pinning that fabric down along the equator. So I'll go ahead and fill in all those gaps with two or three pins to keep my fabric nice and smooth. Once you have your pin line all the way around the equator and the fabric is nice and smooth over the foam, you can use your fabric scissors to trim off the excess fabric that is extending beyond the pins. Once that is all trimmed up right along the equator, you can take out that center pin, and if there's a hole left in your fabric, use the tip of your pin to just sort of scratch that hole out and move the fabric fibers back in to cover up that hole. And now that you have one side of the foam covered, we're going to do the exact same thing on the opposite side. So with the patterned side facing away from you, lay your square of fabric down and lay the uncovered side of the foam on that square, centered to the best of your ability. Go ahead and slide that off and pin it down with a pin in the center just to hold it there while you're working. And now you'll repeat the exact same process, starting with the corners, smooth the fabric over the foam, and pin along the equator. So these pins are basically in line with the pins you've already placed. You probably can't see your equator anymore, but you know that you did your best to place your pins along the equator the first time, so you can use those pins to line up the pins for this side. You'll do all four corners. And once all four corners are pinned, you will now smooth out and pin each of the four sides. And now fill in between those eight pins. Add another pin in between each of them, always making sure to smooth your fabric out before pinning it in place. And now go around one more time and fill in the gaps between your pins with 2 to 3 more pins along that equator, making a nice solid pin line that keeps your fabric smooth over the face of the foam. Once your pin line is complete and your fabric is smooth, carefully trim away the excess fabric extending beyond your pins. Take out that center pin and make sure that you get rid of any hole that stayed there. And now that both sides of your foam are covered, we can get started adding the embellishments that make it look like an adorable little gingerbread face. We're going to start by adding the rickrack trim to make the icing line across the top of the face. And to do this, we're going to measure down from the edge of the foam. So I am lining up my 2-inch mark with the equator on my foam so that I can measure down along each side. And down 1 1/4 inch on this side, I'm placing a marker pin. I'm only pushing it in about halfway because we're just using it to mark that spot. We don't actually need it to stay there for the whole pattern. And now moving down 1 1/4 inch on the other side, placing another marker pin. And this is where we're going to lay our rickrack trim. With your little piece of rickrack, go ahead and line that up across the foam right under the marker pin that you placed at the 1 1/4 inch mark, and the edge of your rickrack should be falling along the equator. So once you have that lined up in the right spot, you can pin it along the equator, stretch it across the foam to the other side sitting just below that marker pin, pin it at the equator again on the other side, and then flip your foam over and do the same over here. So you're just reaching across to where your rickrack started. Pin it one more time along the equator. And trim away any excess trim. You can remove those two marker pins, and now you have added your little bit of zigzag icing across the face of your ginger ornament. And now we know that this is the top of the ornament. The more narrow brown part above the rickrack trim is the top. So we're going to start at the top and cover our raw edges and pins. Using an 11 inch piece of gimp trim, go ahead and lay the short end centered with the top of your ornament. So if you were to hang your ornament from the top center, this is where we're starting that trim along the equator. Pin it in place with two pins. And now wrap it all the way around your ornament, covering the raw edges and pins as you go. This gives it that nice finished look around the outside so that you don't see any of those pins or raw fabric edges. And when you return to the top center, pin it in place with two pins one more time. And trim away any extra trim that is extending past those pins. Now we can add the face. With a 1.5 by 2.5 inch piece of fabric number 2, this is the color you picked for the cheeks of your ornament. Flip this over so that you have it laying with the pattern side facing away from you. And to cut out the circular pieces for the cheeks of our smiling ginger ornament, we're going to use a US dime and trace the size of that circle onto the back of our fabric. And I'm just lightly tracing this with a pen that I had that worked on my fabric pretty easy, just tracing two of these circles around that dime. Once you have those circles traced, go ahead and cut them out using your fabric scissors and take your time. You can go nice and slow to make sure that you are cutting a good circular shape there. So I'm just slowly cutting and turning my fabric as I go to cut right along the circular outlines that I made. Once you have your two little circles cut out, we can now add them to the face, and you can put them wherever you would like them. You don't have to be exact. Make sure they're below the zigzag rickrack trim there. They usually end up sitting about 5/8 of an inch below the trim, but you don't have to be exact. You can put them wherever you like them. And once you have them in a placement that you like, go ahead and just place a pin in the center of each piece to hold it in place. And this is where your white pearl beads come in. As you can see on the ornament, you use the white beads to outline the rosy cheeks on your gingerbread to make it look like they're outlined in icing. So you're going to just thread a pin with a white bead. And when you pin around the edge of the circle, make sure you are pinning a little bit on the circle so that you're holding it in place when we remove that center pin. And you are just going to do this all the way around both circular cheeks on the ornament. And you can take time to adjust and readjust them as needed, but you want to just make a nice, even circle around both pieces of fabric number 2. Once both cheeks are outlined with white beads, you can remove the center pins and again just scratch out any hole that was left by the pin on those pieces of fabric. And now with 5 red beads, you are going to make the smile. So again, you are just threading your pin with your red bead. I'm going to start with my center bead here. I'll move it over just a little bit. And then make a U shape with 5 red beads to make the smile on your gingerbread face. And once that is complete, you can now use black beads to add the eyes. For my eyes, I'm also using black pins, but if you are only using silver pins, that's fine. You could use silver pins for the eyes as well. I just like that the black pins blend into the black beads. And you can play around with the placement of your eyes until you're happy with the little bit of personality that your ornament now has. Now with your 1.5 by 2.5 inch rectangle of fabric number 3 and a 5 inch piece of string, you're going to make the bow. And it's best if you sort of cinch this up from the center. In the middle of your fabric, you want to do a little bit of an accordion fold or just pinching that fabric together from the edges to make your bow. And then you will use your piece of string in the center of that and tie it as tight as you can in the middle of your folded piece. So I'm just tying this string around, making sure it's centered on my rectangle, and then cinching that shut. And once you cinch that shut, you'll have the shape of a cute little bow. I would tie your knot a couple times just to make sure it's nice and secure. And trim off any extra bits of that hanger string. And now thread a pin with whatever embellishments you want to use for the center of your bow. I am using a pink pearl bead followed by a bronze bead cap here. So I'm just threading those onto my pin and then pinning through the center of my bow from the pattern side. So pinning through the front center there. And now you can decide on your ornament if you want to place your bow at the bottom as a bow tie or up here at the top as a cute little hair bow. I'm going to pin mine in the top left here to make a little hair bow for my gingerbread. I'm going to move it up a little too. You can play with that until it's placed just where you like it. And now we just have one more step. We're going to add a hanger so that you have a perfect way to hang your ornament. With a 10 inch piece of hanger string, put the ends together and tie a knot. And I like to cut off those extra little bits there so they aren't hanging out under my bead cap. Thread a pin with the embellishments you want to use for the top of your ornament. I'm using the same pink bead and bronze bead cap I used on the bow. And then just push this pin right through the knot on your hanger string. Untangle it if it got twisted there. Pull your pin all the way through that knot. And now you will pin this directly on the top center of your ornament to cover the raw edges and pins of that trim. So right here at the top center, just push your pin in, use that bead cap to cover any raw edges and pins, and now you have a perfect way to hang your ornament as well. Just as easy as that, your ginger ornament is finished. I hope you all had a wonderful time making this ornament along with me. It comes together so quickly, and there are so many different parts of the ornament that you could change to give your little gingerbread face a different personality every time. We can't wait to see the adorable ginger ornaments that you all make, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.